Dana White, is it true that you don't like me? God damn, man. I'm never going to make it to the UFC. Peace offering, brother. Seriously. An olive branch, if you will. It's a surefire number one comedy, TV, reality show, you know, type thing like that. You got, you know, hookups, Mad in Hollywood. And it goes a little something like this. It's called The Neverending Pussy Hunt, okay? And it stars Kimbo Slice and her B, okay? Before I get back to that, though, there are some important, okay? Fuck, that's what happens when you smoke, like, 10 hits of weed and shit, you know what I'm saying? There's some important motherfucking things that we got to clear up, homeboy. This is concerning people's safety, okay? For everybody, wait a minute, before we get to the safety one, let's do the gender chromosome one, okay? Castor Semenya, you know, that young fine sister from wherever it was, that was kicking everybody's ass, and so they thought they'd fucking, you know, throw a little wrench in her fucking track. We had already talked about that. All she needed was a makeover and to be 18, and when I'm fucking famous, I'd play the violin straight up, all right? Yeah, that was just mean-spirited, okay? And then, homeboy, you didn't tell anybody that Public Enemy were like fucking seers, alright? Seriously, the Kimbo fucking controversy, you know what, Kimbo? A panel of experts was fucking put together and they cataloged your non-existent fucking speed, the fact that you fucking suck probably in every sport that you ever played, the fucking fact that you're about as fucking black as Barney Fife. As a matter of fact, they not only fucking, dude, they said that you have, like, mad recessive white genes in you. And, fucking Public Enemy, man. Listen to this shit. You don't think I'm a brother to check my chromosome. Hoping in and check the stage. I'm declaring the way. Get down. All the prophets are raised. Sing it, kick it like this. Kimbo. Like this, Kimbo. God fucked up, homie. He gave you all the white shit, and he gave me too much. Anyway, yeah, it's like this. Fucking, are you white, Kimbo? Goddamn, son. And this is an important motherfucking safety issue, okay? Cal Worsham did his job with Jamie Hart. This kid that fought Jamie was a super stud, okay? A guy that not many of you guys out there would feel comfortable with fucking with, okay? You would tuck tail and run. And his dream was to get a shot against the champ, all right? Fuck, Cal, did you fucking shake your head and go, they don't know what they're getting into, okay? You did your job. You actually did a perfect job, all right? Tip of the cap. And then to all my friends that call on the phone and listen to what I say to Cal and say to me, you know what, I'm going to fucking walk up and punch him in the face. Oh, my God. You know what, I'm going to avert a train wreck, okay? Because I say shit doesn't mean that Cal Worsham isn't a fucking badass, okay? And actually, many would-be assholes worst motherfucking nightmare, okay? Dressed up, whatever, you know? I mean, he looks fucking about as, you know, unfucking savage. Well, yeah, I mean, nothing personal, homie. But you know what? You can get there. And so, to the people that I like, don't fuck with Cal because he will fucking stomp you, okay? And if the circumstances are correct, he might beat you to death and then fucking get away with it because you attacked him. You know what I'm saying? And to all the guys that I don't like that are kind of saying the same thing, oh, I invite you and attack him. And then fucking I'll come and videotape that shit. And when he demolishes you, fucking we'll put that shit up on YouTube. And, oh my God, it will be a lot, okay? Cal Worsham is no pussy. And, yeah, it goes like this. The Neverending Pussy Hunt, okay? Episode 1, we pick out a prime pussy neighborhood like Coconut Grove near Miami. Oh, yeah, about as good as it comes. And they take Kimbo and they take Dumbo. Oh, no, that's Herb Dean, okay? His sidekick. And they drop him in the middle. They don't have any money. And to win, they've got to get pussy, okay? Okay? They had to cancel fucking episode one because when they dropped him down and they had no money, okay, people started screaming fucking Shutters, clothing, you know, the sheriff was called, and you know what? They had to fucking reschedule. It cost a lot of money. It was pretty fucked up. And then schedule two was, episode two was the same thing, but in a less pricey fucking neighborhood. They went to Skid Row. No money, get pussy. And you know what? As things started to disintegrate, okay, and Kimbo and Herb, they were like, you know what? I mean, it's not like it hasn't happened our entire life. We're going to win this motherfucker. We're going to have to fucking rob a liquor store, okay? And it goes like this. They went up and they asked the hookers the price. The hookers actually doubled their price, okay, thinking to scare them off. And so they said like $200 or $400, and that's all they fucking took. You know, they were being ethical about it. And they went back, and the hookers had doubled their prices again. Funny shit, man. You know what? We come back to the second episode when they got to rob a bank. Hookers are going on strike. It's kind of making all the guys that can't get pussy and have to pay for it pissed off. Crime blows up. Fucking Washington calls and said, you know what? Fucking, will you please buy those two motherfuckers some pussy? And in this fucking... You know what, man? This is some funny shit, okay? If I'm laughing like this, I'm hoping somebody's enjoying this half as much as I am, goddammit. We come to Dada 5000, alright? This is serious, homeboy. I could savagely fuck you up. Oh, yeah, I've seen you. You have nada. And it shows how fucking hungry people are for fucking, you know what, punching, action, excitement. And, you know, it's funny. We could actually get a fucking... a little sit-down talk show, okay, with people that have seen my shit, and then they can react it on TV, and people are going, oh, god damn, ask Steve, the vice president for the North Sacramento chapter of the Vagos, Dana White. I don't fuck with anybody, you know what I'm saying? It's like, because I'll dress like this, man, and I'll just be kicking it, and then someone will start shit, and then I'll be like, you know what, homeboy? And I'll be like, you know, you fuck with the wrong motherfucker, you know, and, now, I won't take my pants off, okay? But, you know, it's like this. I could drop this shit, right? And then to win these, I had to win a state, okay? And got blazing hand speed. And when people fuck around, okay, I sit them down with fucking gashes. They're fucked up, broken teeth, broken noses, blood, knocked the fuck out. That's why when I saw your shit, Kimbo, I actually talked to my homeboys that are badass fighters. And I was like, do you think they paid these motherfuckers to take a dive? Oh, and then OG Kush tells me that you were fucking in a van hunting for fucking bums for $300 to $500 that wanted to fucking get some, what, drug and fucking beer money? So, yeah, you fucking got some chumps, beat their ass. Did you? Did you even land a punch, homie? I mean, you know what? I was trying to see it, and I was like, goddamn, that was like Ali shit. But he was on target, man. He fucking hit him right on a dime, and that's all it took. And, to the greatest ever. Oh my God, if I could be reincarnated, I would come back as Muhammad Ali. Yes. Oh, I don't have to. I'm damn near as fast right now. And Kimbo versus Dan. Play acting. Different fucking scenes. Let's see. Juanita's surrounded by four guys. Kimbo, what do you do? What I do, I go, tease. One. Four guys are three slack job motherfuckers. Boom, boom, boom. Done. Five, could be Phil Baroni stepping up, man, play acting as an asshole, because you're not, and coming in, throwing punches, getting blown up, that's what happened, and then people would be like, oh my God, you know what, Stevia works, and then I wouldn't have to fucking clown Kimbo, and when I was rich, I'm going to kick you down anyways, homeboy. How about Home Depot, Kimbo? Guy said, honey, this is the guy, because what he saw was me shut an entire dorm dominated by blacks down, okay, in the following fashion. Yeah, I fucking heard grumbling, man, because I just told the fucking head houseman that if he fucking said it again, I was going to fucking plant him in the ground, right? And then I laid down, said, roll your shit up, said, fuck you, punk. And In the ensuing scuffle, went, I mean, didn't happen. He went to rat me out, and I was hearing woulda, shoulda, coulda, whoa. And so I got up like cool hand motherfucking Luke, and what I did is I took my fucking shirt off, and I said, okay, motherfuckers, as I'm stretching my arms, I said, if anybody thinks they got fucking something for me, then step the fuck up, shut the fuck up, let's do this, okay? And no one did. I said, that's what I fucking thought, so shut the fuck up, I'm reading my book, okay? I want people, whatever, you know what? Fill it in. And I did that, and what I could do, Kimbo, is unleash hell, like fucking the Roman army on your face, homie. And could it take it? Christ almighty, man. If you didn't have bling, you know what? Play the violin, Kimbo, okay? G-spot, yin and yang. You know what? You might actually get some luck, dog. I did.